In this video, we are going to see how to read a file as an array. The content of the file will be read as an array at a time. So whatever the whole content in a file will be read as an array values, and you can use for each loop to go through the array elements in PHP. Now we are going to see that. So the central syntax is file, then the name of the file. Others are optional. So here, as usual, use include path. It is set to true if you want to search PHP's include path, etc., any other paths. Then context, if you want to explain about your operations, you can write something here. Now we'll see how you can do. Now I just show you the program. Here, see, you in the left hand side, you assign a variable. Now it becomes, after the file is executed, after this line is executed, it becomes an array. So file, then name of the file. This is what you have to give. So now it reads and it will be placed in this array. Now this is an array. This is not a string like what we have seen in file get contents. Now it is an array. So an array, how you can read? You can use for each loop. So for each $array1, that is, you name the name of the array as then key and value pair. We are reading it as a key and value pair. So this is also these are also a user defined variable only. So here you can give x, y, whatever it is, but that will be considered as a key, and after this symbol, this will be considered as a value assigned to that. So like this, it can read. Now we are printing it on the screen. Then one more function, file size. File size will give you the size of the file. So here you have to pass the file name. Then here what we have done is file size. Then we have passed the name of the file. And the left hand side, it is assigned a variable. Now we just print it on the screen. So we will know what is the size of the file. Now we'll see how it gets executed. File 6. So this is that. See here, left hand side, it comes key. Key is here, it is nothing but numerical value. Index, it comes as a key. And to that left hand side, we have this. I'll show you the content of the data file also. This is data 1. I'll show you data. This is the file. So when it reads, you can see the first one will be the 0 index, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. And the size of the file is, it counts the number of characters and it prints it. Now we see one more command, file existence. You would like to check whether the file is existing, then you do the operations. So for that, we have general, that is, we have the command file exists. Now how to do that? So first itself, you are checking whether the file is exist, then only you go inside and do all these operations. Else you just give file does not exist. So this also will work. Now I'll show you the same thing. We'll do if file exists of file name is data.txt. If it exists, then you go inside and do all these things. Else, what you do is, when this off, you can do. Else, CHO, file does not exist. Okay. So, since it is there, it will execute. Suppose I give some data 3, which is not actually in our folder. Now this file is not at all there. So now we'll see what happens. It will give you file does not exist. See, file does not, file size, it is giving that previous file size. As it is remembering the, see, it is taking this. So it is giving the data text. It calculates, because here I have, again, I pass the valid file name. So it gives that. Or else, if I give the valid file name, which is present in that, then it will check, it returns true or false. Now it returns true, and then this value will be, or whatever the process which you are asking it to do within that if loop, that will, if class, that will be carried over.